This video explains the differences among assessments, surveys, and quizzes, and when to use each. It also provides a quick look at the three stages in the survey process. Link time codes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. Assessments is a core application on the ServiceNow platform. Assessments, surveys, and quizzes, as well as some other platform features, all rely on the same underlying technology. Because of this, assessments, surveys, and quizzes have many features in common. But there are also differences among them that give each application the special functionality needed for its particular purpose. For example, assessments allow you to evaluate, score, and rank items from any table and provide normalized weighted results. There are many use cases for assessment. For example, executives may use it to evaluate projects for effective management, and managers may use it to rate and compare vendors' goods and services. With assessments, you can send custom questionnaires to selected users or write scripts that query the database directly, and then compare assessment results for the records using unique graphical views designed to highlight key performance information. Surveys are great for collecting general customer satisfaction data or feedback on a task activity, such as when a request is closed. You can even create public surveys for non-ServiceNow users. Quizzes are questionnaires that can be assigned to one or more users to assess their knowledge of any subject. The assessments and survey management applications are active in ServiceNow instances by default. Users with the admin role can activate the Quiz Designer plugin for the Quizzes application. Let's take a quick look at the Design, Assign, View process for surveys. This general process is the same for assessments and quizzes. Here we're logged in as Mara, who has the survey admin role necessary to design surveys. In the Survey Designer, we create questions by dragging these data type controls onto the canvas and then editing their properties. We can also edit existing surveys here. Let's take a look at this customer satisfaction survey. Here we can change the question, make it mandatory, or modify other settings. But in this case, we just need to reorder the choices. There, that's better. Configuration allows us to provide introductory and closing messages to users, if applicable. And here's where we specify whether the survey is available to anyone or only to specific users or groups. If we specify users or groups here, later, when we assign the survey, only the selected users or groups will be available for assignment. We'll leave anyone selected and save it. There are three ways to assign a survey: manually, schedule it on a particular date or calendar interval, for example, monthly or quarterly, to get a net promoter score, or associate it with a trigger condition. For example, when an incident is resolved, send a survey to get feedback on the caller's experience. Here are all of the surveys in our system. We want to assign the customer satisfaction survey to a customer who recently interacted with the IT service desk. But before we can assign it, we need to publish it, making it available at a URL. If we wanted to assign it to multiple users, we would create a group. To make the survey available to people who aren't logged into the instance, we copy the URL and paste it in an email message or a web page. This also makes it easy to review the survey from the user perspective. In this case, it opens in the service portal because we set the assessment property to yes. As users take your survey, you'll want to review the results. One way to do that is through the overview dashboard, which displays a variety of reports from several surveys. You can add, delete, and rearrange these widgets to show exactly the reports you want to see, and refresh them to display the latest data. Another way to view results at the individual survey level is through the View Surveys module. Each survey record displays response trend and summary charts, which reflect current data at the time the survey record is displayed. And from here, we can drill down into the scorecard to see results at the question level. This should help us make the right decisions to achieve our goals. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.